Hello students, today we will see an implementation of publisher subscriber model by using Java JMS and Apache ActiveMQ. Let us understand what will be the objective of this particular model. Consider there is a topic. To that topic, the subscriber are subscribed. Once publisher publishes any messages with respect to that topic, all the subscriber will receive that message. Now how to achieve this? For that reason, we have Java JMS and Apache ActiveMQ. Java JMS acts as a message broker application, whereas Apache ActiveMQ will provide you the repository where messages are sent and messages are received. So with JMS, JMS receives the message from publisher and it send those messages to the Apache ActiveMQ. Subscriber will fetch those messages from Apache ActiveMQ. In this way, the entire implementation flow goes. This is the diagram I have already discussed, where a topic is there. To that topic, multiple subscribers are there. Client is sending some message related to the topic. Once it publishes such message, all the subscriber will receive that message. In the second diagram, you can observe there can be any number of topics that publisher can be publishing messages to, and consumer can consume the messages from the subscribed topics. These are the major objects that are useful while implementing JMS kind of application. I have already covered these objects in my last video. Let us consider this diagram. With the connection factory, we are going to establish a connection between JMS provider and the Apache ActiveMQ. With the connection class, we will establish a communication between JMS provider and JMS client. From connection, we will derive the session object. This session object will be useful for producing the messages as well as consuming the messages. So you can observe the session object derives message producer as well as message consumer. Lastly, from session object, we will have a message that will be sent by the producer and that will be consumed by the consumer. This message is of any type. For this example, we are making use of text message. Let us see how we can implement. You can observe I have created a class. The name of class is topic producer. I have created another class and name of that class is topic consumer. We will first of all see what topic producer is going to do. Just import the required libraries into the class file. These files are nothing but JMS.star classes. So all these classes are present in the ActiveMQ jar. I'll tell you how to import that jar file. For now, just remember you need to import the required number of classes. Later on, we will have another class related to the Apache ActiveMQ. So we have to import that class as well. Once we start implementing our class topic producer, we are going to implement this with the help of threads. In future, you may want that your topic should be subscribed by many subscribers. So in that case, by creating a thread for each subscriber, we can have similar kind of implementation. So in this particular class definition, topic producer, we will create the ActiveMQ connection factory object. Initially, it will be null. We will set this particular connection factory to the actual connection. So next step, create a topic producer constructor wherein always for every instance you will create a connection with the JMS provider, and JMS provider will in turn create a connection with the Apache ActiveMQ. After that, we will go to the public void run method, which will be executed once thread is started. So I have listed some of these steps over here. Also, the steps are mentioned here as well. In the publisher class, the step 1 is nothing but create a connection factory object. Next, it will be create a connection between client and JMS provider. Then create a session from that connection. Create a topic. Since we are implementing publisher class, it's duty of publisher class to create a topic. To that topic, we will send the messages. Once topic is created, create a message producer which will send those messages. At last, when everything is set up properly, create a message and send that message to the topic. Now these topics are specified with the help of object of class destination. At last, the very important thing, we have to close the connection. Similar kind of steps we have to follow for the subscriber implementation. Again, we will create a connection factory that will hold the connection between Apache ActiveMQ and the provider. Then create a connection, so subscriber will communicate with the JMS broker. Then create a session. Through this session, we will receive the message. Create the topic, or just list out the topic from where you want to receive the messages. So again, a destination class object is playing a role in the step 4. Create a message consumer object that will receive the message, get the message, and at last close the connection. So again, coming back to the producer class or the publisher class, where its run method will be discussed. First of all, create a connection. So with this, I'll create the connection with the connection factory. Now you can observe, connection factory is nothing but the connection between the broker application and the Apache ActiveMQ. So in this way, I will hold a connection with the JMS broker. I will start the connection. Since I have already said that we need to close the connection, so explicitly I am writing connection.start as well. After creating a connection, now create a session. So session object is created here. This session object will be created from the existing connection object. So connection.create session. Now to the created session, we are passing two arguments, that is false and session.auto acknowledge. So this is boolean argument, false and the true. When you want to have transaction with the object, you need to set the true argument. When you don't want to perform any transaction, you need to set it as a false. Now in the next step, we will create a topic. As I said, topic will be created with the help of destination class. So create a destination object and use a method create topic. So with this create topic, we can create any customized topic name over here. So argument to the create topic will be any customized string that you want to set for the topic. So I have created a topic, computer lab 9. In the next stage, what we have to do, connection factory is set, connection is set, session is set, topic is created. Now we will create a message producer. So this message producer will be responsible to produce the messages or publish the messages. So create the object of that and specify the destination. Now what will be destination? Destination will be this topic name. Whatever messages prepared or the created by the producer will always be sent to this particular topic. After this, we will set an extra argument that the producer will deliver those messages in a persistent way. That means everything should be in an executable state. Once producer is created, it's time to create the message. So I have created a sample text message, complete JMS experiment, and this message will be transmitted or transferred to the topic, computer lab 9. So a text message will be created, and whatever string text is there, I am passing this string text to the session object. At last, once the text is embedded into the session object, it's time to send that message to the topic. So producer object will take care of that and it will send the message. At last, as I said, we have to close the all connection. If the connection is not going well, I have written a catch block to catch the exception. Similarly, in the consumer class, what you have to do, again, it will be running with the help of thread. So I'm implementing a runnable interface. I'm creating active connection factory object, which will be null. So whenever the request is there, the connection will be established. When this is possible, when I'm creating an object of topic consumer class, that means a constructor will be executed and the current connection will be established. In the topic consumer class, again we will have a run method. Whenever a thread is created for this particular class, upon executing start of that thread, this method will be executing. The same steps are here. Here we will first create a connection, then we will create a session, then we will find out the topic, or we will create a topic. So the destination in the producer and destination in the consumer shall be same. Here the same destination I am mentioning. Then create a consumer for this particular topic, computer lab 9. So message consumer class is there, create its object, and it will be receiving messages from the topic destination. And what is topic destination? Topic destination is computer lab 9. Later we will write a code to receive the messages. So receive the message and just open that message. So once message is received, I will be displaying that message on the console as well. Once everything is over, do the cleanup, that means close the connection. If connection related issues are occurring, it will throw an exception and it will be cached by the catch block. The last class that I am writing here, it is ActiveMQ main class. So it will hold the main method. So what it does basically, first of all, it will create the connection factory. So the connection factory means nothing but connection between the provider and the Apache ActiveMQ. Apache ActiveMQ is always running with TCP protocol and at port 61616. So whenever you are initiating the communication or the connection with Apache ActiveMQ, this particular script is running and the connection will be established. After that, in a main function, we will create a thread for consumer first, and later we will create a thread for publisher or the producer. So first of all, create a thread for topic consumer. So I will create a thread. This thread will be executed for class topic consumer and it will set the connection factory thread. That means what? It will send this particular address to the topic consumer class. So topic consumer class, where initially the connection factory argument is null, now it is receiving that particular address and the connection factory will be executing there and setting the connection for this particular address. After that, I am starting the thread. So thread is started here for the consumer class. Once thread is started, all this particular thing will be executing run method of the consumer, topic consumer. So it will get executed and it will look for the messages present in the computer lab 9. So by doing this step, we are basically subscribing topic consumer to the computer lab 9. After that, we will create a thread for producer class or publisher class. Again, connection factory will be the argument sent to the topic producer. Initially it was null, and for the created instance, for the created object, it will receive this particular argument, so that the connection will be established between topic producer, that is provider, and the ActiveMQ with this particular address. Next step, it will be executing the start, that means run the thread of topic producer. So all lines of the run method will get executed. So by executing this, it will like create a topic computer lab 9, right? And it will send a message to that topic, that is complete JMS experiment. As soon as it will send this message to the topic computer lab 9, the consumer will start consuming it. Let us see how we can execute this. First of all, see what steps you have to follow. For this particular project, go to the build path configure build path. In the build path, click on libraries, click on add external jars, go to the Apache ActiveMQ extracted folder. You will find Apache ActiveMQ all .jar file. Click on OK. That file will get added to this build path. Click on OK. After doing this, all the errors or all the exceptions will not be there. So we will execute this particular thing. So first of all, understand what steps we have to do. I have already discussed this step, that configure the build path, then start the ActiveMQ in the foreground or in the background. So just copy this particular string and go to the terminal, execute this particular command, and your Apache ActiveMQ will be starting. After that, open the URL. So copy this path, open the web browser, paste this path, hit enter. It will ask you for the username and password. Set username as admin and password also as admin. So you will be viewing this kind of interface. So now you can observe here, queues are there, topics are there, subscribers are there, many options are there. We are interested in topics. So currently there is no such topic. So we will execute this particular class. Main method is present in ActiveMQ main. So I will run this particular class. So run as Java application. Once I execute this, I'll get a message, complete JMS experiment. So let us see, the topic consumer is receiving the message from, or it is receiving the message out of this particular topic, that is computer lab 9, complete JMS experiment. Now look at the interface, just refresh this. You can observe a topic is created as computer lab 9. So in this topic, the message enqueued is 1. So currently one message was enqueued and the same message was dequeued. If you go and see the output in step by step mode or the debug mode, you will see there will be one consumer when we go into the debug mode. So let us run this again. The similar kind of output is there, and just click on refresh. So as many as number of times you run it, that many number of times the message will be enqueued and message will be dequeued. Okay, since this is persistent communication, both producer and consumer should be in execution, then only you can see that how many number of consumers are there. Okay, so in this way we can implement the JMS application with the help of Apache ActiveMQ, wherein publisher subscriber model can be there. Similar to this, we can have point-to-point messaging as well, where the destination can be queues. For any doubt, please mention it into the comment section. Thank you.